Everyone, it's Mal. Welcome back to part two of my tutorial. If you haven't seen the first part, I recommend watching that first. I will put the link in the description below. But if you want a quick rundown of what we're doing so far, it is a appointment scheduling bot that I'm using Voiceflow. And in the first part, I just do a direct call to the Google API to get the times that you are busy. And we do a bit of math to get the times that you're actually available. And so that way you can see here when we offer up times, these are legitimate free times that you are free and you will never be double booked. So where we left off last time is after they confirmed time, basically when it says yes, this is printed and we're gonna go over that later on in the tutorial. I print this just for like debugging purposes to make sure the correct time is being sent to this webhook. Of course, I will delete that if I was actually making this for a client. We're gonna go through how I set up the automation in Make and what it would look like on the client side. This is the first step. We left off at finally picking a time that is available and converting it. This is where I printed the date just to make sure, but originally I wouldn't have this connected to anything actually. And then at home, so this was the component. So we give all the available dates and now we grab all the information for booking. So we say, thank you, let me grab some information. What's your full name? And then I wanna just get their first name. So I just use a split and get the first part. Note if they only give you a first name, it's not going to mess anything up. They give you a three-part name like Marianne Smith. I don't know why that was the first name, but if that comes up, it's still just gonna give you anything before the first space. So they could give you 10 names. It doesn't matter, you're still gonna get their first name. Then we grab their email and then their phone number, which they can skip. I create an event name. I do this just because I wanted to do consultation with and then using their name. Plus I hard coded my name, of course. I'd be like the client's name. This is a description. I originally was going to put something in here, but I just have it set as test right now. You don't have to do this part. You can go directly from the event name to creating the event, of course. And then at the end, I do say thanks, their first name. I've successfully booked you in at that time. Expect a confirmation email as well as a calendar invite shortly. So, and then I was gonna go on to ask them how the booking experience was, but I don't have that built out right now. Anyways, this is what we are here for. So I pass through the event name, start date. I'll tell you why I don't have an end date, their full name, their email, their phone number, and then again, the description, but I just have that set as test right now. So it's not very useful. So in Make, the first one you want is the custom webhook. And I'm not gonna go too into detail with this because I'm kind of assuming you already know how to use Make. This isn't really a starting from absolute scratch how to set everything up. So if you need something more detailed, I'm sure there's a tutorial out there, but let me know. Anyway, so this is where we copied the address. Then we want to create an event. Make sure your email is added here. And so it's going into my primary calendar. This is where I pass through the event name into the event name. It's not an all day event. You can have it set as all day event. I don't use an end date because, oops, you can either use an end date or duration. So I do duration of 1 hour and note the format is hour and minutes. So I have it like that. The description, you can make it whatever you want. I guess technically if I was throwing in a description, I would put that here like that. I don't have a location and this is a reminder in minutes. So this is 24 hours. I just want to send them a 24 hour reminder. And the attendees are the client and myself. Show me as busy. Send a notification about the event to all guests. We briefly went over this. Guests can modify. I put no recurrence and add a Google Meet, yes. And the next one is send an email. I wanna send an email to the client, subject. This is where actually I would have put the event name. So consultation with Mal and Mal. And then this is where I just said thank you for showing an interest, yada yada, that we saw earlier. And these are just line breaks. So that is that. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and test this out and I will show you what I mean when I say that one of the invites is not showing up for some reason. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to figure this out. And that is part of the delay, so I apologize. I still haven't been able to figure it out. I also haven't really had a lot of time. I have asked for help though in other... you can hear my dog walking. I have asked for help in a couple of Discords, and I haven't gotten a response or a solution. So I just thought I would go ahead and make this anyways because it does have, I think, some useful information. And maybe someone's going to watch this and know exactly what's going wrong. So hopefully someone can tell me. Anyways, let's keep going forward. Let's pick a time. It'll ask me to confirm, and then it's going to start asking me for all my data. Number. As you can see here, everything was successful, and sometimes it takes a second. Okay, so it is here. This is the original client, like your client, their client, so who I just booked as. This one is my calendar, so you can see it showed up. This is the email that I just put in. This other one, the malware email, is the one that I have set up as the client, like the owner, and then this is their user. So you can see, though, I did successfully. Oh, my chef's plate subscription. As you can see here, I've also been testing it for a little while, but this is that thank you email at the end. This last Gmail sent an email, it's a confirmation. And then this is the invite to the event. But the original client, the person who you're making the bot for, I can't seem to get an invite on that side. In the Google Calendar, so like obviously my email and everything is correct because I had to verify it. It did get the invite, or well, it didn't get the invite, but it got the event in their calendar. And so, that works. And I go send notifications to all guests, and the client's client gets the notification, but the client doesn't get the notification for some reason. So that's kind of what's been holding me back from publishing part two, like I said. But I still don't have a solution, so I apologize. But if someone knows what I'm doing wrong, please let me know.